modern day music, what do you think of it, and are there any artists that stand out for you?
Well, look, that's what's happened with music, is that it's diversified to a huge extent, and that's been accommodated by, on radio, there are radio stations that play particular types of music exclusively, or they have shows that play that kind of music exclusively. So chances are that if you're interested in, say, reggae, you can just listen to reggae 24 hours a day and not really explore any of the other options. And I think that's a bit of a shame, because you only really pick up interesting things by getting exposed to other forms of music. I mostly listen to classical music these days, and or jazz, with occasional bits of pop thrown in, but no, I really haven't kept up with what's going on these days. But when I do hear it, there are some interesting things going on, some great players. So John Mayer, for instance, has picked up the guitar aspect of playing, and he's got a kind of double life going on, where he plays, you know, melt-in-the-mouth pop music, but he's also a really, really interesting guitarist. And when he gets on a show like Crossroads, he really lets fly, and he's a terrific guitarist. So there's an example of somebody who's sort of got his feet in both worlds.
You mentioned classical and jazz that you listen to mainly now. Why is that? Is it the quality of the music?
I suppose I started off life as musically, anyway, as a chorister, and so I've got a bit of a soft spot for classical music as a result of that. And I don't know, I find it's less constricted composition-wise. I mean, you can listen to classical music all day without actually hearing the same thing repeated. And you could take a fragment out of a piece of classical music, like a few seconds out of a classical composition, and create a piece of pop music from it. So if you extrapolate that over an entire piece of classical music, you could probably write half a dozen pop songs minimum from just a piece of classical music, just borrowing pieces from classical music. So, and it's almost the same as jazz. I mean, jazz is perhaps owes its origin to the blues, but it's taken it a bit further, and the technical requirements are greater, and it's just great fun to listen to. I'm not a jazz player by any means, but I've always enjoyed listening to jazz music, starting off with, you know, your Ella Fitzgeralds and so forth when I was a kid.
Going back to the song you're best known for, I'll Be Gone, I'm very interested to know, at the time you were writing the song, did you have any idea of how enduring and popular it would become? Some artists say that they're writing a certain song and constructing it, and they go, that's a good song, that's a hit. Did you feel that way?
Look, I think you feel that way about a lot of songs that you write, but in the case of I'll Be Gone, it was virtually the first, in fact, it was the first song that I wrote for Spectrum with a new band in mind, and I wasn't writing a lot in those days. I always thought it sounded like, it always helps if you're writing from the heart, you know, and someday I'll have money. Money isn't easy to come by, but that still rings true somehow.
Oh, dear.
but it wasn't until we played it for a bit and we demoed it, but it wasn't until I added the harmonica to it, stopped playing the guitar and took up the harmonica and added that particular harmonica riff to it, that it had that instant identification with people. And I think before we got to record it, we really kind of knew that it was making a connection with people. And in fact, Ross Wilson, when he heard us rehearsing, he'd been over to the UK and come back again with Procession. When he came back, he donated us one of his songs, which was Make Your Stash, and he was listening to us playing the rest of our stuff, and we played I'll Be Gone, and he just said, that's the one. So we had endorsement from the public and from musicians, so yeah, we kind of knew by that stage. But when I was writing it, it was just a song from the heart, so I wasn't really thinking about anything other than a song.
Such a hot, hot day. I can't get anything done today. Nothing done at all. I can't get nothing done at all. I'm sitting here in Melbourne town, and nothing but nothing is going down till the sun goes down and I can't breathe again. Some people love it, but I can't say. I wish that old sun would just fade away and leave me in peace and quiet on my own again. I can't open that old fridge door, that's the only air tone I got. I can jump into a cold shower, hang around in there for an hour or two while I figure what to do, till that old south wind makes his mind up to arrive and make it feel good to be alive.
What was it like working with Ross Wilson from Daddy Cool and Mondo Rock fame?
Well, I had a couple of years working with Ross in a band he had called The Party Machine, and after my band The Chance broke up, which was only took about 6 months of living in Melbourne before we just fell over, I joined Party Machine playing bass and played with Ross for a couple of years, and in that time we moved from playing, you know, a few of Ross's songs to near, you know, 80-90% of Ross's songs as the Party Machine's repertoire. So that gave me the incentive to write my own songs. Yeah, no, Ross was just inspiring to work with, and he's a great band leader. He knows exactly what he wants, and he knows what to get and how to get it. So, look, I've worked with him subsequently and still stay friends with him. He's a great guy.
Yeah, he's still releasing great music. I think quite recently as well, he had an album out, I think maybe earlier this year or late in 2010.
Yep.
I want to go back to a time when you played your farewell performance. It was at the Dallas Brooks Hall in Melbourne, and it was on the 15th of April 1973, coincidentally my birthday.
Oh.
Not that I remember, but I just want to know, can you recall the vibe and the feeling of that concert after the success that Spectrum had at the time? Was it a feeling of closure or sadness or anything like that?
Look, there was. It was an era that was over, and we felt at that stage that Ray Arnott was leaving the band, our drummer at the time, and we'd already lost our keyboard player, and we just felt that we couldn't keep the Spectrum thing going after 4 years. So there was a certain amount of sadness, but there was also a challenge because in the audience was Tim Gayes and Nigel McCarra, and they were the nucleus of the next band, Aerial, and we knew that we were going down to Armstrong's the next week to start rehearsing a totally new repertoire with Aerial, so there was a sense of continuity as well. But look, that was a fantastic concert, and the feeling that we got from the audience was just indescribable, and although it was in 1977, we did the whole thing again with Aerial when that finally broke up, and we did another final concert at Dallas Brooks Hall.
Is this the